Let's look at the advanced uploading of files as an example of the settings you can use in the Dropbox. You can see the two red and asterisk fields are assignment name, so I'll put in a sample here, and description. Some of the settings, if I scroll down here, are grade, and so if I have a 25-point assignment, I can scroll through here and put the points on there, and then when I go back in to give the student feedback, one of the items I can select is the points that I would give that student. So that allows me the flexibility of doing some pretty seamless online grading that would then be able to be exported and imported into my PowerSchool gradebook. I can open the assignment by date and close it by date, and then I can choose whether or not to have late submissions. And so there are a couple of ways to manage that, but you can actually have the due date and time be a stamp, and so when that window closes, you can close that box and maybe have another Dropbox for late assignments if you want to allow that, or disallow it altogether, or you can allow students to have a late submission, and then of course it would be date and time stamped when they turned it in. The advanced uploading of files file size settings here you can change up to 32 megs. I can have the students delete their files, which means if they made a change or something, wanted to go back within that window of time before it was due and make that change, they can do that. I can set the number of files that can be uploaded, have students put notes on their files before they send it to me, and a couple of other items in there. And then there's the settings for groups. So if I want to have Dropboxes just separate for my period 3, period 4, period 5, I'd want to create those groups, and I'd want to mark those as separate groups. And then I want to make this visible to students so they can see that. I'm going to save and return to course. And now I have my advanced uploading sample listed there.